If you're an airsoft sniper and you're all about camouflage, the rifle camouflage is one of the most important pieces of your kit. A black rifle will stand out and it will give away your position. Painting is one way to do it, but lots of people don't want to paint their gun, and also the paint itself is sometimes not enough because it doesn't break up the silhouette as good as this classic sniper rifle camo right here. This camo was designed for the SSG-10A1, but it also fits the SSG-10A2, the SSG-24 and many other classic style looking sniper rifles. The reason why it is very universal is because of the elastic cord here at the bottom. Even if the stock is a different shape, it will fit. And also if the handguard here is a little bit different and if the auto barrel diameter is different, you will still be able to fit it. We can guarantee it for the SSG-10A1, the A2 and also the SSG-24. For other rifles, you can give it a try, but most likely it will fit. With some modification, it will definitely fit. Starting here from the back, we have the stock cover here with the leaf suit on. Also here, keep in mind that we try to keep it ambidextrous, so if you don't want those leaves to be in the way when you're aiming, you can always just cut them off. Everything is based on the mesh material, so if you want to add additional artificial camouflage like the LC1, LC2, LC3, raffia camo, all that, this is an example of how you can do it with this cover. On the inside of this piece here, we have a silicone coated friction material elastic bands, so it really pulls tight onto the stock and this does not move. This is not the kind of cover where you put it on and then you run around for 5 minutes and then it's upside down on your rifle. This was really important for me, that this is not a rifle that goes against you. This is supporting your playstyle and this is breaking up the silhouette of your gun. Moving into the front, you can see the entire front section, and here the scope is actually combined together with the rest of the rifle. So this is one piece cover, and the scope cover is quite universal. It is designed for the Norwich scope, but any 50mm and also some of the 40mm will work perfectly because there's many adjustments that you can do to the scope cover. Here in the back we have the Velcro, which also allows you to access your adjustment here, the zoom, but you can access it also through the cover. If you have a little nub on there like on the Norwich scope, you can still adjust it without actually taking it off for quick adjustments in the field. When it comes to the bolt handle, safety, trigger and all that, we made sure that nothing is in the way, that you can operate your rifle just like normal. And again, this is not, you know, getting caught in your action or anything like this. Now, because the scope and the cover is connected to one piece, you will not experience that it kind of like turns around and that your mag well is not open anymore. Anything like this is avoided by connecting those two pieces. When it comes to placement of the magazine on your rifle, this is kind of like shoelacing. So if your magazine well is, let's say, here or here, you can just change this lacing just like on a shoe, you know, just lace it further here and start moving it here as well. I do recommend also lacing it through the trigger guard to pulling it tight there that it cannot move forward. When it comes to the scope cover, you can adjust the length. Here you have those buckles. So if you're not using a scope extender like here, you can basically just pull those tight on both ends. It's gonna move backwards then if you're using a shorter scope. Also in front here, you can adjust it to the diameter of your scope, and you can also change how wide the opening is, because mostly when you camouflage your sniper rifle and you aim towards your enemy, if he looks at you, he will see this perfectly round circle of your scope, and here we avoid that by pulling it more tight. When it comes to the length of the gun, here is actually a suppressor attached, as you can see right here. So this is a short barreled SSG-10. Here we do have a long barreled SSG-10, and this is the way the cover comes. So this is not cut, not modified. That's how you get it. If you want to use it with a short barrel, the best way is to just change the lacing again. Just cut it off and lace it again to get a result just like here. When you're putting on the cover, take the time to actually loosen all those lacings. It's just when, you know, putting on hiking boots, take the time, loosen the lacing so you can get in there easily, and then you can tighten it up nicely. Same here, so really take the time, loosen up the lacing, put the sock over your rifle, and then just tight everything down. Make sure that you have clearance on your magazine, make sure that you have clearance on your bolt, trigger, and all of that. If you want to get to the hop up, the best way is to just put your finger here underneath, go to the hop up and just adjust it right here, just like that. Now, because hop up adjustments are different on every gun, we did not cut it open here. If you want to cut it right here, feel free, take scissors, just cut it open to access. If you don't want to do it, again, just thing underneath and you can adjust it right there. When it comes to TDC adjustments, because this is mesh based, you can just put the Allen key through those holes and you are good to go. So if you always wanted to camouflage your rifle, but you know, maybe you don't want to paint it, or you want to get additional camouflage on top of the paint job that you did, this is a great option. And you know, honestly speaking, I tried many ways to camouflage my rifle. I had those wraps that go around, there's like burlap and all kinds of stuff that you somehow cable tie to your rifle, and I was never really happy, and this is why we developed this cover. I played with it, it is very nice, it doesn't get into your action, you really can't feel it. It's lightweight, it's nice and sturdy on the gun because of the anti-slip silicone material on the inside, because of all the elastic cords that, you know, pull it tight onto the rifle. So this is a great option if you want to camouflage a classic style sniper rifle. If you're wondering how you can adjust your scope, that is very easy. You can either just do it through the mesh, so you grip the towers and you turn it, you can still hear the clicks, so you can still do the adjustments. If you want to get real access to it to change batteries and all that, you can just open the Velcro right here and then access the towers just like that. Here you can also see the silicone coated elastic material that really caused the friction and to make sure that everything stays in the way. When it comes to mounting your sling, this is still possible. The studs are exposed here on the A1, also here the front stud. You can also mount the bipod if you wish to do so. And for the A2, you can just, you know, slip it slightly forward to access the QD sling seal. And then also here in front, you can just, you know, lift it up slightly, put the QD there, and you're good to go. When it comes to those covers and different sniper rifles, don't hesitate to modify them. You can take scissors, cut it. This mesh is rip stop, so it's not gonna be that you cut a little piece in there and then it just comes off and flies off your rifle. So don't hesitate about that. Feel free to modify. You can, you know, start cutting leaves, for example. If you say, you know, this leaf might be in my action, I could grab it together with the bolt handle, take scissors, just cut it off, and you're good to go.